Muchos piensan distinto, sienten distinto, buscan a Dios o encuentran a Dios de diversa manera. En esta multitud, en este abanico de religiones, hay una sola certeza que tenemos para todos. Todos somos hijos de Dios.
Holy Father said today, notwithstanding new developments and the emergence of situations which are at times painful and even tragic, migration is still an aspiration to hope. The Pope noted that migration offers benefits both to the receiving nations and to the nations from which migrants come. Important role through initiating dialogue, welcoming and assisting with legal issues, mediating with the local population. More than this, the Church is a source of hope for migrants, who often experience disappointment, distress, and loneliness, and therefore everyone is worthy of being welcomed and supported.
He describes migration as a phenomenon, quote, which demands to be understood and confronted with sensitivity and a sense of justice. He calls on the Church to proclaim and bear witness and reflect a spirit of charity while observing the law.
Pope recalled that the attacks in Brussels were committed by young people born in Europe, but who'd not been integrated in society. He also recalled that 1 in 10 Swedes is an immigrant or the son of immigrants, but they are perfectly integrated.
There were immigrants to blame for this riot in Stockholm. There is an increased level of crime. Assaults are up, rapes are up. This is just according to police statistics in Sweden.
Pope Francis is undoubtedly one of the biggest con men, one of the biggest frauds, one of the biggest liars in all of world history. He came out last year and said that it makes him basically nauseous to hear that Europe has Christian roots and shouldn't open itself up to the most radical, barbarous groups flooding out of the collapsing Middle East and North Africa. He's promoted a one-world religion. He has attacked America's sovereignty and warned us that we shouldn't elect President Donald J. Trump. And now he's come out in a public statement and said, Islamic terrorism does not exist. Merkel, the embattled Chancellor of Germany, has also come out in the same weekend, just last weekend, and said it doesn't exist and we need, quote, more Muslim refugees. Yeah, a bunch of military-age men pouring into the country. Here's the article. It's up on Infowars.com. It links directly to Pope Francis's own statements released by the Vatican. Pope Francis declares Muslim terrorism, this is a quote, Muslim terrorism does not exist, close quote, as he continues to set the stage for a one-world religion. What in the world is he thinking? Michael Schneider writing says, when I first started seeing headlines that claim Pope Francis said that Muslim terrorism does not exist, I thought that couldn't possibly be true. After all, who could possibly deny that Islamic radicals are engaged in terrorism? In the last 30 days, there have been 127 Islamic terror attacks, the total of 25 nations. And in 2016, global terror attacks set an all-time record high, were up 25% from the year before. And he goes through Christians being slaughtered, the UN admitting there's an epidemic of it, what happened in Libya, Syria, with hundreds of thousands of Christians being killed or displaced. And Pope Francis sits there arrogantly saying it doesn't exist. Just like we don't see people in New York yesterday at a women's march doing the call to prayer, or women putting on hijabs in D.C. or Berlin, or just like we don't see all these weird, bizarre Islamic groups actually leading the protest and demonstrations. No, we know the left and the globalists have allied themselves in an unholy alliance with Islam, Wahhabist, Sunni Islam out of Saudi Arabia, and that they are the destabilization force that is supposedly going to, quote, repopulate Europe. So the globalists take over Europe and the U.S., teach us not to have kids, then destabilize the Middle East, open up the borders, and bring in the most oppressive anti-family, anti-woman, anti-Christian groups you can imagine, who dress their little kids up with suicide bombs and have them march in and blow up Christian churches. It's unbelievable. This Pope Say what you want about Catholics in the past, but this Pope used blackmail dealing with pedophilia in the Vatican to overtake it and overthrow the church and bring their system in. And the good news is, not just conservative Catholics, but Catholics across the board are almost unanimously in leadership opposing him because he is a monster meant to destroy one of the oldest Christian institutions in the world. The West is on its deathbed. The globalists want it to fall before they bring in their technotronic global tyranny. And instead of the West falling, it's time for parasites like Pope Francis to fall politically, where everyone completely recognizes what a monster he is. They say the devil is the father of lies. Well, I ask you, is it true that Islamic terror does not exist? Is the Pope telling you the truth? Or is the Pope lying to you? And clearly he's lying, not just here, but in many other ways. He believes you will take his office, speaking ex cathedra, and will then accept a great delusion like Revelations talks about, and a great lie, all because the father or the pontiff told you so. Well, he is a father. He's a father of lies. He's a son of Baphomet by any measurement.